The two most common ways to measure temperature for process control and automation are with thermocouples and resistance temperature devices, or RTDs for short. An RTD is just a device whose resistance changes over temperature in a predictable linear way. They're great for applications up to around 600 degrees Fahrenheit. Because RTDs are typically made from a very fine wire wrapped around a ceramic core or created using thin film technology, they provide accurate, repeatable results over the long term. But they're also fragile, they have a long response time, and they're bigger than thermocouples. For wider temperature ranges, up to a couple thousand degrees, you'll need a thermocouple. They create a small voltage across a junction of two dissimilar metals when exposed to a temperature gradient. This produces a less accurate reading, and it can drift over time. But it also means they don't have any ceramics, so they're not fragile, they have a much faster response time, and they're smaller. Now, when we say fragile and we refer to the size, we're only talking about the element. They're both packaged in the same size probes, and once packaged, they're both very robust. Thermocouples are identified by a letter. There's a whole bunch of these, but the most common ones are J, K, and T, which designate a specific temperature range. Thermocouple wire is color-coded like this, so you can simply pick one up, look at the wires, and immediately tell which one it is. Now, don't use regular copper wire to extend thermocouples. It'll mess up the readings. Copper wire is fine for RTDs, but you'll want to make sure it's shielded and that the shield is grounded at one end to reduce the noise. RTDs come in a variety of types, with the most common being a PT100. It's made from platinum, and it's been calibrated to be 100 ohms at 0 degrees C. Automation Direct's PLCs handle a wide variety of RTDs, including PT1000s, JPT100s, CU10, CU25s, and NI120, just to name a few. Once you've selected your temperature sensor, just connect it to your PLC's thermocouple or RTD input module. Automation Direct's temperature measurement modules convert that temperature directly into memory, which means you don't have to write any code to get the temperature values. Check out the other videos in this series for more helpful tips and live step-by-step demos of exactly how to use temperature sensors with Automation Direct PLCs. And if you need help, please don't hesitate to contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help you. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any support questions there. The forums are not regularly monitored by tech support.